In this video, we are going to discuss about stack organization in computer organization. Stack is a collection of items. Stack works based on the principle of LIFO. LIFO stands for last in, first out. Last in, first out means the element which is inserted last into the stack will be deleted first from the stack. The best examples for the stack is the coaches of a train. If we take the train, so we will have coaches like this. So this is the first coach, this is the second coach, this is the third coach. So likewise we will arrange. So the element, the coach which is attached last will be deleted first from the corresponding train. So this is about the definition for a stack. In stack we use a register called SP. SP stands for stack pointer. Stack pointer always stores the stack's topmost element of the stack. Let us assume that these are the elements in the stack. So this is the topmost element. So stack pointer always points to the stack's topmost element of the stack. Okay. Mainly we can perform two operations on the stack. The first operation is push operation. The second operation is pop operation. So push means inserting an element into the stack. Pop means deleting an element from the stack. We can implement stack in two ways. The first way is register stack, whereas the second way is memory stack. So stack is implemented in two ways. The first way is register stack, whereas the second way is memory stack. So first let's see about the register stack. So how we are going to implement the stack with the help of registers. Let's see the block diagram here. Block diagram of a 64 word register stack. So that means our stack totally stores 64 words. So here we are implementing the stack with the help of registers. Let us take the block diagram. So this is nothing but our stack. So what is the capacity of the stack? The capacity of the stack is 64 words. So let the items are like this. So let it be 0 address, let it be 1, let it be 2. So likewise, what is the last address? The last address is 63. So 64 word means we can have 64 words from 0 to 63. Next here we have a register called data register. Data register always contains an item. If you want to perform push operation, then data register contains an item. So that item will be pushed into the stack. If you take pop operation, then an element will be popped from the stack and the corresponding element will be stored in data register. And we have two registers. They are full and empty. So the size of the full and empty is 1 bit. So full may contain either 1 or 0, whereas empty may contain either 1 or 0. If full value is 1, then we can say that the stack is full, whereas if full value is 0, then we can say that the stack is not full. So likewise, if empty, here we are writing as EMTY. EMTY is name of the register. If EMTY value is 1, then we can say that the stack is empty. Whereas if EMTY value is 0, then we can say that the stack is not empty. Now let us perform the push operation. So we know what is push. So push means inserting an item into the stack. So before performing the push operation, so the initial status here is the initial value of the SP is 0. The initial value of the stack pointer is 0. As well as initially the stack is not full. So the value of full is 0. So full is 0 means the stack is not full. As well as the value of EMTY is 1. Why? Because initially the entire stack is empty. So EMTY value is 1. Let us write the code for push operation. Okay. Here the point is, the first element will be stored at the location 1. Second element will be stored at the location 2. Next element 3. Last but one 63. Whereas the last element is stored at location 0. So where we are storing the first element? The first element is stored at location 1, address 1. Whereas the last element, that is 64th element, is stored at address 0. Okay. In push operation, we are doing like this. So first, initially, where is SP? SP is at 0. But we have to store the first element at address 1. So we have to increment SP value. So SP arrow SP plus 1. So that means we are incrementing. So let us write on top so that it is visible to us. So let us write the push operation. So SP arrow SP plus 1. So now stack pointer will be incremented by 1. Okay. So what is the initial value of SP? 0. So 0 plus 1 means 1. So now SP will be at 1 location. Okay. Stack pointer always points to the topmost element address. Okay. Now this is the topmost element. Okay. Next, data register contains an element. So we have to push that element onto the top of the stack. So DR contains some element. So that element will be pushed onto the top of the stack. Okay. Here M stands for memory. Let us assume that data register contains an item called A. So that A will be pushed into M of 0, M of 1. So M of 1 means what? A. So likewise the element will be pushed. Let us perform push operation one more time. So SP arrow SP plus 1. So what is the previous value in SP? 1. So 1 plus 1 means 2. So now SP will become 2. So now SP will be at the location 2. Next, M of SP arrow DR. Let DR contains an item called B. So now that B will be pushed into M of 2. So likewise the elements will be inserted one by one. Here the last but one item will be stored at 63. So let that item is B. Now let us perform push operation. So we know that the first element will be stored at location 1, whereas the last element is stored at location 0. Here what is the address here? 63. So how we can represent 63 in binary notation? We know that 2 power 4 means 16. So 4 bits are needed for representing 16. 2 power 5 means 32. 2 power 6 means 64. Okay. So totally we require 6 bits. 6 bits. So 6 bits, 111. So this is nothing but 63 in binary notation. So 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. So 32 plus 16 means 48. 48 plus 8 means 56. 60, 62, 63. Okay. So let us perform the push operation. SP arrow SP plus 1. So we have to add 1 here. So if we add 1, 1 plus 1, 0 with a carry 1. 1 plus 1, 0 with a carry 1. 0 with a carry 1, 0 with a carry 1, 0 with a carry 1, 0 with a carry 1. But here the size of the register is 6 bits. So it cannot store 1 here. Okay. So now what is the value here? 0. So the in decimal notation this is nothing but 0. So now SP will be at 0th location. SP will be at 0th location. So DR, M of SP implies DR. Let here the item is B. Let here the item is A. So A will be stored in M of 0. Okay. So likewise we can perform the push operation. Okay. Now where is SP? SP is at 0. So if SP value is 0, then we can say that the entire stack is full. So let us write the statement here. If SP is equal to 0, then we can say that the stack is full. So full stack is full means full arrow 1. So full arrow 1 means the stack is full. So that means here there are no more empty locations in the corresponding register. So we can say that the value of empty is 0. So empty is 0 means the stack is not empty. So we can write as EMTY implies 1. Okay. So if you take the first push operation, let the locations are like this. If you take the first push operation, let the locations are like this 0, 1, 2. So like this we can have several location. So the initial value of SP is 0. So what is the logic here? SP arrow SP plus 1. So 0 plus 1 means 1. So now SP is at 1 location. M of SP arrow DR. Let the DR item is A. So A will be stored here. Next, if SP is equal to 0. But what is SP? 1. 1 is equal to 0. Condition is false. So this body won't execute. So next we can perform one more push operation. So likewise we can perform the push operation. So this is the code for push operation. Now let us perform the pop operation. Okay, let us perform the pop operation. So for the pop, let us write the code. So pop, so we know what is pop. So pop means deleting an item from the stack. So here the first item is stored at address 1, whereas the last item is stored at 0. So first this A will be 0th item, A will be deleted. So next this 63 item will be deleted. Next 62 item will be deleted. So likewise deletion will be done. So first we have to extract this item and store the corresponding item in data register. So how we can extract that item? M of SP arrow DR. So SP is at 0 location. So what is M of 0? A. So A will be extracted and that A will be stored in data register. Okay. So now this item is deleted. So what we have to do? We have to store SP value at its previous location, its next location. So for that we have to decrement SP value. So here how many bits we are using? We are using 6 bits. So 6 zeros. 6 zeros. So how we can represent 0? 6 zeros. So while performing the pop operation, we have to decrement SP value. SP arrow SP minus 1. So 0, 0, minus 1. So we know how to perform subtraction operation. In order to perform the subtraction operation, calculate the 2's complement of the second number. 2's complement of the second number. So here what is the second number? 1. So first we have to represent this one in binary notation. So 000001. So we have to calculate 2's complement for this number. For that let us calculate 1's complement. So what is the 1's complement here? 1's complement means 000100. Next we have to calculate 2's complement. So 2's complement means we have to add 1. So if we add 1, then what is the result? All 1's. All 1's. So we have to add all 1's here. If we add all 1's, 2 zeros, then what is the result? All 1's. So 6 1's means what? 63. So now SP is at, so this item is deleted. Now SP is at 63 location. Okay. Let us perform pop operation one more time. So DR arrow M of SP. SP is at 63. So M of 63 means B. So that B will be extracted and B will be stored in data register. Next SP arrow SP minus 1. So 63 minus 1 means 62. So likewise the item will be deleted. Okay. So likewise all the items will be deleted. Let us assume that this item is deleted as well as this item is deleted. Okay. Let us now let us assume that the item at 1 is deleted. If the item at 1 is deleted, after that what will happen? Stack pointer will be at 0th location. Now the entire stack is empty. So we can say that if SP value is 0, then the entire stack is empty. If SP is equal to 0, then the stack is empty. So empty means what? EMTY value is 1. That means the stack is not full. Okay. So we can write as full implies 0. Full arrow 0. Okay. So here the stack is full when SP value is 0, as well as the stack is empty when SP value is 0. But the scenario is different. Okay. So if SP value is 0, then we can say that the stack is empty. So EMT value is 1, as well as we can say that the stack is not full. So not full means full value is 0. So in this way we can implement register stack. Now let's see the second implementation. So what is the second implementation? Memory stack. We know that we can implement the stack in two ways. The first way is register stack, whereas the second way is memory stack. Now let's see about the second implementation, that is memory stack. So memory here means the RAM. Here the RAM, the memory is divided into three portions. The first portion contains program segment. The first portion contains program segment. Program means it contains a set of instructions, whereas the second portion contains address. Address means it contains some operands, whereas the third portion is stack. This is nothing but stack. So we can have elements like this. Okay. So this is nothing but stack portion. Let the address of the program is 1000. Starting address of the program is 1000. Let the starting address of the address is 2000. Whereas the starting address of the stack segment is 3000. So next element will be stored at 3001. Likewise, let the last element is 4001. Here in program section, we use just program counter register. We know that program counter always contains address of the next instruction to be executed. In address section, we use just address register. Address register stores address of the operand. Here we use a stack pointer. Stack pointer always points to the stack's topmost element of the stack. Here what is happening? Here the addresses are decrementing. So first 1000, next here addresses are incrementing here. So next 1001, next 1002, next 1003, like that. So here what we are doing is, here we are storing the first element at 4000 address. The first element at 4000 address. Next element at 3999 address. So here the stack is growing by decrementing the addresses. If you take the previous one, the first element is stored at the location 1. The second element is stored at location 2. So likewise, the stack is growing by incrementing the addresses. Whereas here the first element is storing at 4000, second element 3999, whereas the last element is stored at which location? 3000 memory location. So initially SP will be at 4001. Initially SP will be at 4001. Let us write the code for push operation. So where we have to store the first element, here also we can have data register which contains the operand. So here we have to store the first element at 4000 address. Okay. Next element at 3999 address. So what is the initial value of SP? 4001. So 4001 minus 1 means 4000. So first decrement SP value. So now SP is at 4000 memory location. Let data register contains an operand called A. So place the data register in M of SP. So what is data register? A. So that A will be stored in M of SP 4000. Then after that, what we have to do is, we have to check whether that stack pointer is greater than the uppermost value of the stack or not. So what is the uppermost address of the stack? 3000. Whereas now what is the stack pointer address? 4000. So 4000 is greater than 3000, so there is no problem. We can perform the push operation. So beyond 3000, it is not possible to perform the push operation. Why? Because this section is address. So let the address here is 2999. So 2999 is less than 3000. So it is not possible to perform push operation in 2999 memory location. Okay. So that is the condition for checking the push operation. Okay. Let us perform push operation one more time. Now SP is at 4000. So 4000 minus 1 means what? 3999. So we have to check whether this 3999 is greater than this uppermost limit register value or not. So 3999 is greater than 3000. So we can store the value here. So what is the value? Let the value is B. So B will be stored in this location. So likewise, we can perform the push operation. Let us perform the pop operation. So we know what is pop. So pop means deleting an item from the stack. So let us assume that here the topmost element is 3999. So we have to store M of SP into DR. So DR implies M of SP. Okay. So what is M of SP? M of 3999. So what is M of 3999? B. So B will be stored in data register. Okay. Then after that, decrement the stack pointer. So what is the next value? So this value will be decremented. So and it will be placed here. So here what we have to do is, while performing the pop operation, we have to check whether this address is less than 4001 or not. So here 3999 is less than 4001. So this is nothing but lower limit stack value. Lower limit stack value. So 3999 is less than 4001. So we can perform pop operation. 4000 is less than 4001. We can perform pop operation. Likewise, we can perform push and pop operation with the help of the memory stack. So here memory stack means what? The main memory is divided into three segments. The first segment program segment, second segment address segment, third segment is stack segment. Now let us discuss about applications of the stack. Here mainly there are three types of expressions are there. The first expression is infix expression. Infix expression means operator appears between the operands. The second expression is prefix or polish notation. Prefix notation or polish notation. Prefix means operator appears before the operands. And the third one is postfix expression, or we can also call it as RPN notation. RPN means reverse polish notation. Reverse polish notation. So postfix means operator appears after the operand. There are mainly two applications of the stack are there. The first application is converting infix to postfix. Postfix means reverse polish notation. Let the expression is like this: a plus b into c plus d. So this is nothing but infix expression. Why? Because here operator appears between the operands. Operator appears between the operands. So this operator appears between this operand and this operand. So we have to convert this infix expression into postfix expression. Here this is first expression, this is second expression. So first let us evaluate this expression. So what is this expression a plus b? What is postfix expression? Operator appears after the operands. So that means a b plus. So here we are writing operator after the operands. Let us evaluate this expression. Here cd plus is nothing but operator. So this operator appears after the operand. So here cd plus. So here which operation we are performing here? So we are performing which operation? Here we are performing multiplication operation. So this is nothing but star. Operator appears after the operands. Or if you want, we can evaluate with the help of a stack and postfix expression like this. Here if the symbol is an operand, then we have to place it into postfix expression. So this is nothing but postfix expression. This is nothing but stack. Next we have plus an operator. If it is an operator, then push it onto the stack. Next we have operand. If it is an operand, then place it in the postfix expression. Don't bother about this right parenthesis. Next we have star, but in stack we have plus. But here the star priority is higher than plus. So we can push star onto the stack. Next left parenthesis, don't bother about left parenthesis. Next, what is the next one? Yeah, it is better to consider about parenthesis also, so that we can get the correct expression. So what is the first one? Left parenthesis. So if it is a left parenthesis, then push it onto the stack. Next, a is operand, so place it in postfix expression. Next, plus is operator. Plus here, what is the operator here? Left parenthesis. So plus is having highest priority than left parenthesis. So we can push it onto the stack. Next, b means operand, so place in postfix expression. Next, right parenthesis. If we get right parenthesis, then we have to pop the stack until we will get left parenthesis. But we should not place left parenthesis in postfix expression. So pop plus and place it in postfix expression. But we have to pop the left parenthesis, but should not place left parenthesis in postfix expression. Next we have star. So if it is an operator, but the stack is empty, so push it onto the stack. Left parenthesis, push. Next c, operand, so place it in postfix expression. Next plus, but here what is the topmost? Left parenthesis. So plus has higher priority than left parenthesis. So push. Next d, operand, so place it in postfix expression. Next right parenthesis. Right parenthesis means pop the stack until we will get left parenthesis. But don't place left parenthesis in postfix expression. So pop the stack and place in postfix expression. Pop left parenthesis, but should not place in the stack. Next here we have star. So pop the stack and place it in postfix expression. So this is the expression here. Now the second application is evaluating postfix expression. Evaluating postfix expression. So we have to evaluate postfix expression. So let the expression is like this. So 2, 3 plus, 4, 3 minus star. So we have to evaluate this expression. Here the logic is very, very simple. If the symbol is, if it is an operand, then push it onto the stack. So 2 is operand, push it onto the stack. 3 is operand, push it onto the stack. Next to plus. If the symbol is plus, then pop the topmost two operands from the stack, perform the operation and push it onto the stack. So here the first operand is 3, second operand is 2. So 3 plus 2 means 5. So push it onto the stack. Okay. Let the next one is 4. So 4 is operand. So push it onto the stack. Next one 3. 3 is operand, push into the stack. Next to plus. So we have to pop the topmost two operands, 3 and 4. Perform plus. 3 plus 4 means 7. Push it onto the stack. Star. So pop the topmost two operands. 7, 5. So 7 into 5 means 35. So 35 is the result. So this is about stack organization. So stack organization means we have to explain about how we can implement stack with the help of register, how we can implement stack with the help of the memory, as well as applications of the stack such as converting infix to reverse polish notation, such as postfix expression, as well as evaluating postfix expression.